Good morning, children. Today we'll continue our lesson, Every Drop Counts. In the previous video, we saw how in the earlier times people collected rain water to use it for the whole year. Now, children, today we are going to study about the importance of water and how each drop of water is very precious for us. Nowadays, we all waste so much of water, and due to which we face shortage of water. Okay, in India, there are many states which face such shortage of water, and one such state is Rajasthan. Besides Jaisalmer, there are many other places in Rajasthan which face such shortage of water. Here it rains only for a few days in the entire year. So what the people of Rajasthan do is they collect all the water when it rains and use it for the whole year. And how did they manage with so little rainfall? Now look at this picture. Every house of Rajasthan had a way to collect rain water from the roof of their house. That means there are huge pipes that start from the roof and go under the ground where they built storage tanks. You can see in dotted lines the storage tank is built under the ground. Now whenever it rained, the water went from pipes to the storage tank built under the ground. This water they used throughout the year for multiple purposes, like washing, cleaning, watering the plants, etc. This is called rainwater harvesting. Nowadays, we are facing shortage of water. Do you know most of the people in India are now harvesting rainwater in their own houses? They are doing this to overcome the shortage of water. Now, people of Rajasthan also made large pits like this in the form of lakes. Wo bahut bade gadde banate the in which rain water was filled. These were called lakes. They also made big tanks like this, which were deep and was called johads. In these lakes and johads, they collected all the rain water and used that water throughout the year. These lakes and johads had many advantages. Advantages means fayde. Now, kya fayde the wo? The water around these lakes and johads also seeped into the ground. Seeped means soak kar lena. Ground is pani ko soak kar leta tha. And thus, groundwater was collected. And this groundwater was taken out by different kinds of wells. Look at this well. The water can be drawn out of the well manually. Hum bucket ko rassi se bandh kar well se pani nikal lete hain. And these are called step wells. They are built deep under the ground with steps going down and coming up. They are also called bavdis or baulis in their local languages. They are actually built to go in and get the water instead of drawing water with a bucket. Now, these step wells were first built in the state of Gujarat. From there, people of Rajasthan learned how to make it, and they also started making these step wells. From these states, these step wells spread to all the parts of India, especially the northern and western parts of India. Now, these step wells are made after every short distance in Rajasthan. Har thodi duri par ye bavdi bani hui hai. And why were they made after such short distances? Because in olden times, people used to travel with their goods and animals. While traveling, they and their animals needed a lot of water. उन्हें बहुत प्यास लगती थी। दीज स्टेप वेल्स हेल्प द ट्रैवलर्स वाइल ट्रैवलिंग बिकॉज वाटर वॉज नीडेड इन द हॉट क्लाइमेट ऑफ राजस्थान। दे फिल्ड वाटर फ्रॉम दी स्टेप वेल्स इन देयर मशक्स। कैन यू सी दिस बैग? दिस इज कॉल्ड मशक, विच वर लेदर बैग्स विच दे कैरीड वाइल ट्रैवलिंग। Okay, people of Rajasthan also built piaus at some places for these travelers, as they felt it was a good thing to give water to thirsty travelers. And now when we are talking about travelers, long, long ago there was a traveler called Al-Biruni. He was from Uzbekistan. He visited India and saw these step wells and ponds. He was very impressed and surprised to see the skill of the people of India. His country also faced shortage of water. So what he did was he wrote about these skills in his book so that he can use these skill in his country too. Al-Biruni Indians ki in skill ko apni country mein use karna chahta tha. Okay. So now children, you saw how people saved water. We should also try not to waste water, as water is very precious for us. All right, now children, watch this video and do task 8 in copy.